Thanks for tuning in to Mirror Now. I'm Avni Raja and you're watching Investor's Guide, the show where we make personal finance simple, a guide which helps you on how you can manage your money and your investments. So without any more delay, let's straight get to it. Joining me on the show is Feroz Aziz, Deputy CEO, Anand Rathi Wealth Management. Feroz, thank you so much for joining us. Let's in fact start off straight with the topic that we're going to discuss today, which is an emergency fund. Now, this is one of the most fundamental and crucial steps when you begin your financial planning journey, when you begin the process of getting your money and your investments in order. So an emergency fund is something that is one of the first things that you need to do and put aside. So let's start, Feroz, by understanding what really is an emergency fund.
Avni, an emergency fund is a pool of money set aside for some emergencies, as the name suggests. As life progresses and unfolds, you will have things which are not planned. So planning for the unplanned by creating a pool of money set aside, which is reasonable enough to sail through surprises, is called an emergency fund.
Okay. And how much ideally should be there in that emergency fund when we are trying to, keep that aside?
See, I think emergency fund should be an optimal amount, not too much, not too less. It should ideally be, as per our opinion, it should be about 6 months of one's regular income or salary, which should take care of most of the surprises to ensure that you can sail through smoothly. So 6 months off your salary should be your emergency fund to begin.
Right. So just for our viewers to understand this a little better, we're talking about assuming you have no income for the period of 6 months. For an example, you should be able to dip into this savings and dip into this emergency fund and live off it without any additional income coming in. So you have to calculate your living expenses. You have to know how much you spend on a monthly basis comfortably so that you get everything met. And that is really what this fund is all about. Feroz, if I've got that explanation correct. But let's also understand, what are the kind of emergencies that we are talking about here? Because very often people think that I don't need this kind of an emergency fund without realizing how much it could come in handy.
Yes, it could come in handy for example, a job loss or a pay cut, especially in the contemporary situation of the pandemic. It's not unheard of. So that's one critical one. The second is you might have some medical emergencies which overshoot your medical insurance by the employer or by the personal self-bought policies as well. So you need that extra cushion to take care of some medical support. Maybe your policies don't cover all your dependents. Maybe your parents are too old to be covered. So that could be the second example. The third example is some loss to property. And you need to replenish that. For example, if there is something wrong with your car and you need to have another car, maybe a used one, but you need to have a bridge funding for something like that. So there could be different kinds, loss to an asset, which is very useful, or loss to an item which you're consuming, job losses, medical emergencies. These are a few examples where people have found this concept of emergency fund very handy when the wolves are knocking on your door. You need this support and the financial stability it brings along.
Okay. The other question, Feroz, that arises from this is where do you then keep this emergency fund in terms of, making it some kind of an investment, because it's something that needs to be easily accessible. Obviously, when there's an emergency, you don't have advance notice and very often you need the money perhaps in a matter of hours or overnight.
See, here you want to make sure that you have accessibility to your money, liquidity in the investment which you have bought or the parking which you have chosen for yourself, but also an optimal usage because this emergency fund will last long periods of time because you might just run an emergency fund of 6 months for the next 10 years. So optimally utilizing that money to earn some return for you is also important. So accessibility, liquidity and an optimal return is critical. So what fits the bill in terms of filling all these three criteria, to my mind, is a mutual fund, which is a liquid mutual fund, which has no entry exit loads and is more tax efficient than a savings bank account, for sure. So the chosen emergency fund parking is a liquid fund, which comes under the mutual fund.
Okay, right. And Firoz, the other point here, of course, is we are living in extremely uncertain times at the moment. In a pandemic, there are a lot of people where jobs have been lost, where salaries have been cut. And the thing here is you don't know how long this is going to last, how long perhaps it's much harder to perhaps get a job these days. What do you then do when this emergency fund runs out? Or is there anything additional? Would you recommend maybe having a larger corpus whenever you're able to, kept aside as part of this emergency fund? How do you deal with such a situation?
Abhi, the concept of having 6 months salary in an emergency fund is that once you see an adversity, you will have to change your spending pattern. See, if I've had a job loss or a pay cut, I will have to first immediately cut my expenses wherever I was being far more flamboyant or discretionary spending, as we call it. So to answer your pointed question, Avni, if you have a 6 month emergency fund, and if the adversity comes knocking on your door, ensure that you're able to last the 6 month salary for 12 months by making sure that you budget the expense well. That's point one. Point two is that when you've parked this money and had this emergency fund, you please ensure that if you have any outstanding debts on the credit card, those need to be paid off with the emergency fund immediately. Otherwise, that's an early sign of getting into a debt trap, which is another larger topic for another day. But immediately when you see an adversity, the first thing to do is use the emergency fund and settle all the debt, which will cost you interest if you kept them held. For example, a moratorium. If you had an emergency fund, you might now have had to take a moratorium, which makes sure that you will have further burdens on your interest obligations once this moratorium is lifted, as of now, August 31st.
Yes, absolutely. Some extremely important points there, Firoz. And moratorium is something that we will touch upon going ahead as well. But on this edition, thank you so much for joining us. That's all the time we have left. But on our next episode, we are specifically going to talk about health insurance. And now you have COVID-specific health policies. So whether that makes sense, all of those questions regarding health insurance, we'll answer for you on the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching.